Hi, this is Riddick Big Daddy Bo, two-time former world heavyweight champion, and you're watching Cool True Sports.
True School Sports.
True School Sports.
There you go, champ. Thank you.
Hello, hello? Hello?
¿Dónde habla? No, él habla. ¿Qué?
All right, Brennan Taylor here, True School Sports. I'm with the man that I call the evil genius, Luis El Chivo Perez, and the unified champion, IBF and WBA champion at 154, Jason Banana Rosario. How you guys doing today?
We're doing great. You know, we just finished for a 12-round sparring session. You know, we're feeling good. We're doing great. The champ is looking great, ready for the 26th.
I can see that, man. You got the stunner shades on.
You got to look good. Dice que ¿cómo te sientes hoy?
Oh, me siento en perfectas condiciones, me siento bien, me siento motivado, decidido y realmente me siento más que todo bendecido por Dios.
Dice, I feel in perfect condition, you know, I feel great, I feel very, a lot of motivation and most of all, you know what I mean, he feel good that God is helping him go through this camp.
Okay, absolutely. I want to kind of take it back to his last fight because that was the fight that really put him on the map in the minds of a lot of boxing fans. Why do you feel like the Julian Williams fight went so like perfect almost was a great performance? Why do you think it went so well?
Yeah.
Dice
que regresando un poquito a la pelea de pasada, esa fue la pelea que te llevó a conocerte. ¿Por qué tú crees que la pelea fue tan cómoda para ti? ¿Cómo pudiste, por qué tú crees que pudiste dominarlo como lo dominaste en esa forma? ¿Cuáles fueron las claves, para eso?
Primeramente, yo confiaba plenamente en que Dios me iba a dar la victoria y luego el trabajo que hicimos aquí, el trabajo que hizo Chiro, el condicionador, mi entrenador de base, Juan Vicente de la Cruz, realmente todo eso combinado con la bendición de Dios, me dio la seguridad y la certeza de que iba a ganar. No fue cómoda la pelea, pero con el trabajo y la bendición de Dios estuvimos la victoria.
He said first he thanked God, you know, for the opportunity and for helping to go through what he went through. Also, you know, why he went the way he went is because his preparation. He never had a training camp in his life. It was the first time he had a training camp. He trained 16 weeks. You know, the work the his coach me did with him, his conditioning coach and nutritionist, you know, Ramon Hayes, you know, his mental strength coach Mike, and he's a trainer from ever since the kid Vicente de la Cruz, you know, the work that everybody put in on those 16 weeks, that what got him that confidence, you know what I mean? He went, you guys see how confident he was going into the fight. And when everybody gave him no chances, he was completely confident, you know, didn't let that bother him. He went all business, as you guys saw, and that's what made the fight. It was not an easy fight, of course, but it was a fight that he was able to dominate pretty much completely because his work that he did for 16 weeks.
Absolutely. You know, Jason is 25 years old, and, you know, I've watched a lot of his fights. He seems to mature quickly. He's maturing quickly as a fighter. So how does he feel he's matured going from the Williams fight to the Charlo fight?
Él dice que tú tienes 25 años ahora. Él ha visto en cada de tus peleas que tú te vas madurando más y más y más. ¿Cómo tú sientes que de la pelea de William a esta tú has madurado mucho más como persona y en el ring especialmente, que es lo que él está preguntando?
Bueno, realmente una diferencia es la tierra. Hemos visto que en cada pelea traigo algo nuevo. Lo he demostrado en base a lo que he estado haciendo. La única pelea que tuve en aprietos fue con Jorge Cota y luego de ahí caí a la mano de Chiro y ya ya pueden ver cómo, cómo salimos al aire.
He said, yeah, I've been my maturing a lot from fight to fight. You know, the I think the fight that he had a hard time with Jorge Cota before he came to train with me. He said, hey, you guys realize once I came to train, you know, with me, Luis Chiro Perez, you saw the difference from the Cota fight to his fight to the next fight with Julian Williams. And now you guys are going to see the difference from the Julian Williams fight to the Charlotte fight. You know, I'm learning every day. You know what I mean? This is only the beginning of Jason Rosario.
Absolutely. How did you guys meet? I don't know how you guys met. So
well, well I mean, I've known him ever since he was a kid. You know what I mean? They've been on, wanted to send him to me. First, you know, it didn't materialize. They send him somewhere else. He always had heard about me, wanted to train with me. You know what I mean? His manager sent him somewhere else. He would not continue where to send him, in California. And he didn't like it there. He didn't like the way he trained. And then he asked his manager to please send him with me, that he wanted to train with me from that moment on. And that's exactly what he did. You know, they brought him here. We had a great chemistry, you know, we're kind of pretty much like a father and son now, you know what I mean? He felt very, very, very comfortable with me, and you guys saw the difference from winning a split decision against Cota to a dominating performance against who was regarded number one in the world at the moment at 154, Julian Williams.
Absolutely. You guys seem to work really well together, and I'll ask both of you guys the question, you both can answer. What do you believe? What's the best part about working with Jason, and for Jason, what's the best part about working with Lewis?
Dice que él puede notar que la combinación de nosotros, una combinación perfecta, que él ve que nosotros trabajamos como mejor de lo que otro equipo que él ha visto. ¿Entiendes? ¿Qué es lo que de mí, y también me hizo la misma pregunta, tú la contestas primero y después la contesto yo, qué es lo que tú ves de mí o qué de mi parte que tú te sientes tan cómodo conmigo y es una combinación ganadora?
Bueno, primeramente, aparte de la química que hacemos, lo que más me identifica con Chiro es que inmediatamente llegué aquí, comenzó a tratarme como un hijo. Hasta el momento me trata como un hijo. Y ahí arriba del ring se preocupa como que si yo fuera su hijo. Cuando pasa algo, lo que sea, él está preocupado y me cuida y o sea, realmente aparte de su sabiduría que tiene una sabiduría inmensa, cada cosa que me dice, cada cosa que me corrige, me explica el porqué de la corrección.
The first, you know, our chemistry is great, you know, he always take care of me ever since the moment he got here, you know, I take care of him like, you know, like a son. Other than that, you know what I mean, he's talking about me, you know, his knowledge, you know what I mean, in the ring, he not only telling me to do this, he telling me why I need to do it, and the reason why I need to do that, you know what I mean, and that's very important for me. I like to hear why, you know, do this move, why that move is important to do it like that, and he always had treated me like a son in the ring. I dream like a son, and that's a chemistry that he never had with anybody before. And now me answering that question, vice versa, working with Jason Rosario is once again, it's a blessing. I saw the talent he had right away, how big and strong he was. You know what I mean? All we needed was just do those little touches. You know what I mean? Like I told you in the last fight, you know what I mean? He still got a lot to learn, and we beat Julian Williams. We got a lot to learn. So, you know what I mean, I saw that he, I saw his talent, I saw what he needed. It was that type of attention, you know, that type of detailed training that I present. You know what I mean, like I said, working with him is a blessing, it's a beautiful thing. And once again, you've seen the results so far.
Yeah, like, you guys work together very well, and like, I know from talking to you personally that the training is very, very, very intense. So I know he's going to be more prepared than most fighters would for a championship fight. But I'm kind of going to the fight, Charlo fight. For both of you guys, how do you feel he, Jason matches up with Jermell, and is he the best opponent Jermell's ever fought, in your opinion? And he can answer as well.
Yeah, I'm going to ask him first.
Ask him first.
Él dice que él ve que una química tremenda entre nosotros. Él ve que tú has mejorado muchísimo. Él dice que yendo en esta pelea, él sabe nada más por hablar con nosotros que nuestro trabajo y nuestro entrenamiento es mucho más intenso que muchos otros boxeadores que van a pelear por el campeonato mundial, ¿me entiendes? El trabajo intensísimo. ¿Tú te ves como el oponente más duro que Jermell Charlo ha tenido en su vida?
Realmente no lo veo así, lo va a ser así el 26 de septiembre. Yo me estoy preparando, no digo ser el mejor, lo voy a demostrar. Y creo que el 26 de septiembre Jermell Charlo va a probar y a saber realmente que es una pelea dura.
He said, I don't actually don't feel that's the big fight for him. Actually, he's gonna know I'm the big fight for him. You know what I mean? And I know it. You know, I don't feel I know it. You know what I mean? I'm coming well ready. You know what I mean? Coming on fight day. You know, Jermell Charlo going to know who Jason Rosario is. The world going to know who Jason Rosario is. Coming well ready. You know, humbling. You know, working humbly here behind closed doors to show the world who's the best 154 pound the world. He doesn't need to say it. He want to prove it that day. And after that day, then we will know who the one, you know, middleweight best fight in the world.
Absolutely. So he's obviously has a reputation for being a very big puncher. But aside from the punching power, what other things about Jason Rosario do you think he'll show the world when he fights Jermell Charlo?
Él dice que tú siempre has sido conocido por ser tremendo pegador. Aparte de pegador, ¿qué otras cualidades tiene Jason Rosario el día de la pelea con Jermell Charlo? ¿Cuáles son tus otras cualidades?
Bueno, realmente vengo con como
140. I got 3 minutes.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Vengo realmente con una caja de sorpresa. Sé pelear. Si me veo la necesidad de boxear, lo hago. Sé pelear a la media, o sea, no tengo incomodidad de hacerme cualquier estilo. Como venga Charlo, esa noche yo iré desenvolviendo mi trabajo.
Yeah, I feel I'm growing to a complete fighter. Other than being a puncher, I want to prove that I have all the tools for whatever Charlo bring that night. He feel he can do it all, you know. He got it demonstrated that day on September 26th. Whatever Charlo bring, he's gonna have an answer for.
Okay, absolutely. I'm looking very forward to it. Our last question. Right now, there's a lot of Dominican fighters on the come up. Right now, Jason's kind of like he's the ambassador for Dominican boxing. So, if he beats Jermell Charlo, what kind of message would that send to the rest of the world about Dominican boxing?
Él dice que últimamente hay muchos boxeadores dominicanos que están tocando la cima grande. Se está escuchando mucho ahora de los boxeadores dominicanos. Tú eres la cabeza, ¿me entiendes? Tú eres el que está arriba de todo ello, ¿me entiendes? ¿Qué clase de mensaje, si nosotros cuando le ganemos a Jermell Charlo, qué clase de mensaje tú le estás dando especialmente a los boxeadores dominicanos que están empezando y que quieren subir y llegar a donde tú vas a llegar después de ganar a Jermell
Charlo? El mensaje es más claro y más preciso que le puedo dar a los boxeadores es que no importa dónde vengas, no importa de dónde salgas, con la fe puesta en Dios y con el trabajo, todo se puede.
The message that I have for all the Dominican guys coming up, you know, it doesn't matter where you're coming from. If you're coming from a poor place, no food, no nothing, you know, it doesn't matter where you're coming from. You know, first, you know, believing in God, you know, believing in yourself. If you believe in yourself and you work hard enough, you can definitely make it, just like he did. He know special other than anybody else coming from there. He just wanted it. He wanted it, and he worked for it hard, and now he's here. So that's my message that I got to all the youngest Dominican fighters coming up.
Well, there you have it. Jason Rosario and Luis Perez.
Thank you very much.
Thank you guys for talking to True School Sports.
And we'll talk after September 26th.
Absolutely.
Sure.
After September 26th. All right.
Thank you.
Are you that girl, that one girl's manager,
Issa Larry? Yeah, she was here too for 2 weeks.
I saw that. Like, I followed her a while back, and then she followed me, and then I saw she was in South Florida. I said, why is she in South Florida?
2 weeks, okay, yeah.
Yes, you're a busy man.
Yeah, and I have Aaron Aponte. I have Trinidad Vargas, so we're trying to make pro debuts. It's very hard without the shows.
Yeah, there's no gate.
There's no club shows, and they need to make the traditional.
Shalom, gonna find out how big and strong Jason is. And he's working.
Lewis, can I grab one more water?
Got as many as you want, my friend.
He just touched it.
See, I know.
Yes! He just put it in there. He's not even swinging it.
I know.
He just touched it.
He just touched it, Lewis?
He just touched it.
A luck tap.
Yes! On fight day, he ain't gonna touch.
Forget about it, yeah.
He ain't gonna touch. I know.
So you watching his fight? You watching all his fights at the house? Yeah. My son and I?
Yeah.
That's how I said he's gonna tear him up.
Oh, we're gonna tear him up.
Yeah. Yeah. I think he's gonna give a good humble and trouble.
Yes!
Harrison didn't do it, but he will.
Oh, yeah,
I'm gonna tell my son, he's gonna finish him.
Yes! I mean, Tony will bust him.
Yeah.
We're gonna run over him.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
We're gonna bust him. I'm gonna be punishing for him.
Yes! He's not coming to play and dance.
No,
he ain't coming there for laughing.
Yes!
Do his business for one. Yeah.
I remember you told me in January that, like, he's one of the only fighters in boxing who's, like, physically and he punches hard and he's physically strong.
Correct, yeah. He's one of the rare guys where he can have a huge puncher and also Also, he's physically strong. You know, you don't find that too often.
One of the top trainers right here.
That's right.
Right here.
Top trainer and top manager.
I got going on over here. Check this gym out. I love coming here.
Yeah.
You've been doing it, my brother.
That's Peter Kahn, for those of you who don't know. That's Peter Kahn, one of the best managers in boxing. We here right now. Louis, what's this gym called? What's the name of this gym? What's the name of this gym?
It's Pain Boxing Facility. Pain.
It's the pain. Oh, there you go. Pain Boxing. So we're here at the Pain Boxing Facility. We're watching Banana Train, Rosario, before his big fight with Charlo later this month, the unification fight. We got killers all around the gym. Young killers, upcoming killers, old killers.
This is Chick Shane Mosley, and you're watching True School Sports.
All right.